Out of My Mind by Sharon M. Draper, Chapter 22. The next 2 weeks passed in a whirlwind. In spite of my little display of weirdness that Tuesday in class, I showed up at practice on Wednesday afternoon as if nothing had happened. Maybe nothing had. I was just being me. I'm not sure what the others thought. They said nothing about it. So, like all the other team members, alternates and regulars alike, I stayed every day after school to practice from 3:30 to almost 6 o'clock. I still couldn't get over the fact that I was part of a team. Okay, truth. There was the team, and then there was me. And we were in the same room, but we weren't quite a team. They appreciated the fact that I usually got the answers right, but when Mr. Dimming gave us a multiple choice question to answer, I had to think for only a moment, then hit the correct letter on my machine. But lots of preparation involved fast and furious back and forth discussions, and I had trouble adding anything to what was being said. Most of the time. One of the longest syllable words in the English language is screeched, Connor announced after one afternoon as he chomped on a raspberry Twizzler. That's a good word for melody, Claire said as she snatched his candy and took a bite. I couldn't respond and no one else bothered to. What do you call that dot that goes over the letter I, Elena asked the group. I knew the answer, but it took me too long to spell out the word. It's called a tittle, Amanda answered quickly, like the brain of a fifth grader. Oh, snap, said Rodney. I had planned to say snap when she said that too, but I was too slow. The group had already zoomed on to another question. Gee, they talk fast. Who was the first child born in the American colonies, Rose asked, reading from a huge stack of 3x5 cards in her hand. Virginia Dare, Elena answered. Okay, my turn. She flipped through her own cards, color-coded. Who was the first Miss America? That's dumb, Connor said. They're not going to ask stupid girl stuff like that. You don't know, Claire asked him. Of course I know, Connor replied with a snort. Margaret Gorman, in 1921, she was 16 and probably looked better than you. He and Rodney were the only ones to laugh. Rodney jumped in then. I've got a nasty question. Where's pediculosis? Without missing a beat, Rose answered, when you've got a scalp full of head lice. Ew. Do you know that from personal experience? Of course not. I was just looking for a hard word, Rodney told her, and he and Connor didn't laugh at that time. You want a hard word? I've got one, Amanda told the group. What is hexterodactylism? That seemed to stump all of them for a minute, so I had time to tap the number 6 followed by the word fingers. Then I pushed play so they could all hear my answer. Good job, Melody, Elena said. How does she know all this stuff? Claire whispered to Rose. She's smart, Rose said, flipping through more cards. But she'll look odd on TV, don't you think? Claire continued, as if I couldn't hear her. I was ready for her. I typed a couple of things the night before, so all I had to do was push a button. TV makes lots of people look funny, I had the machine say. Maybe even you, Claire. Ooh, look who's got snaps now, Connor hooted. Good one, Melody. If I could have danced, I would have. But as quickly as that moment happened, it disappeared. The team zipped on a rocket-paced speed, feeding off one another's knowledge and skill. At the rate they were going, there was no way I could jump in quick enough. I listened, however, and remembered it all. What's the only rock that floats? Pumice. How many chromosomes does a human have? 46. What was the first state to allow women to vote? Wyoming. What's Mr. Dimming's first name? Wallace. We all cracked up after that. At the end of every prep session, Mr. Dimming gave us another official quiz from National Headquarters. Since those always consisted of multiple choice questions, I always did well, but I wanted to be like the rest of them as we studied. One Thursday, in the middle of a practice session, Rose's mom ordered pizza for everyone and had it delivered to the school. Your mom rocks, said Connor. You're easy to please, Connor, Rose replied with a laugh. Everyone rushed to get the hot, spicy-smelling slices from the box. I was starving like the rest of them, but I just sat there. Don't you want some pizza? Elena asked me. I'll go get you a slice. She never said much during the practices, but she took lots of notes, and she usually scored pretty high on our practice quizzes. Not hungry. How could I explain to her that without Catherine or my mom or Mrs. V, I wasn't able to eat? I had to be fed like a baby. And I made a mess even then. When my mom came to pick me up, she asked me if I wanted to stop by Pizza Hut on the way home. I just shook my head.